Hello guys, this is a video on the topic indeterminate forms. This is a topic in section A for ISC people of class 12. CBSE mein we have done this topic in, you know, small glimpse in class 11 itself. So we shall understand indeterminate form. The chapter is not too big of chapter of, but jitna bhi iske andar content tha, usme se approx 50% has been eliminated due to this bifurcated and reduced syllabus format in this year as well as the previous year. As in, I'm talking about 21 and previous year, that is 20 syllabus. So first of all, let us discuss what is indeterminate form. So if we recall the class 11th limit concept, कि हमने लिमिट के लिए दो बातें देखी थी, दैट लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू ए एफएक्स, ये एग्जिस्ट कब करेगा? ये एग्जिस्ट तभी करेगा जब हम बोलते हैं लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट इज इक्वल्स टू राइट हैंड लिमिट। लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट को हमने कैसे सिग्निफाई किया था? जस्ट ए के पावर में छोटा सा माइनस साइन दे दिया था टू सिग्निफाई लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट, एंड राइट हैंड लिमिट को हमने किया था लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू ए प्लस एफएक्स। एंड नीडलेस टू मेंशन कि ये ए माइनस का मतलब होता है एनी वैल्यू लेस देन ए, एंड ए प्लस का मतलब होता है ग्रेटर देन ए। बट इट विल बी वेरी मच इनकरेक्ट टू से एनी वैल्यू, बिकॉज जब हम लेस देन ए या ग्रेटर देन ए की बात कर रहे हैं, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ वेरी मच नियर वैल्यू, एज इन ए से छोटा बहुत नजदीक, द चेंज शुड बी एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल। ग्रेटर देन ए की अगर हम बात करें तो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ वेरी नियर वैल्यू विच इज ग्रेटर देन ए। अगर मैं सिमिलरली वन माइनस की बात करूं तो डेफिनेटली वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट माइनस टू। One minus signifies maybe 0.995. In similar perspective, one plus का मतलब three नहीं होगा। One plus का मतलब we are talking about 1.005 or maybe 1.1 at times, but not these two values. So this has to be taken care of. तो ये already हमें पता है, this is the theorem for evaluating limit. इसके अलावा हमने दूसरा limits के बारे में क्या सीखा था so far? That किसी भी लिमिट को इवेल्युएट करो, लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू ए एफ एक्स, वी कैन डायरेक्टली गिव आंसर एफ ऑफ ए, प्रोवाइडेड एफ ऑफ ए बिलोंग्स टू रियल नंबर। हमें तभी आंसर एक्सेप्टेबल होता है जब आंसर रियल नंबर सेट को बिलोंग करता है। फॉर सम कॉज इफ द आंसर डज नॉट बिलोंग टू रियल नंबर, वी हैव वेरियस मेथड्स, वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डायरेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूशन, फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड, रैशनलाइजेशन मेथड एंड एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा। The need of making so many methods was to this only, that every single method, let as in every single limit with direct substitution, will not give us real number, and that is why we have to incorporate certain methods. हम जो indeterminate form की बात कर रहे हैं, वो one such format है जहाँ पे हमारा answer real number नहीं आएगा। मतलब what are the various indeterminate forms we can think of? So make a note. One, first one, 0 by 0 form. This is indeterminate. Infinity by infinity form, this is also indeterminate. इसके अलावा various formats are there जो कि हमारे syllabus में नहीं है this year. Infinity minus infinity, or it can be 0 multiplied by infinity, or it can be 0 to the power 0, or it can be infinity to the power 0, or it is 1 to the power infinity. These are yet various formats of indeterminate, but in our syllabus this year we just need to focus on these two formats, that is 0 by 0 and infinity by infinity. One good part in these two formats that they both will be dependent on one particular rule, which is called as L'Hospital's. So various people pronounce it differently. You can also call it as L'Hospital rule. L'Hospital is also correct pronunciation. So basically, what does this rule say? We'll come to that. But before we proceed into the rule, we can see the 0 by 0, infinity by infinity. What is one thing common here? That the given question, the given function has to be in fractional form. We shall be having a numerator and a denominator. A numerator and a denominator is mandatory for applying L'Hospital rule. What is the rule? That is secondary for the timing. हमें पहले समझना है कि format of the question क्या होना चाहिए. वो एफ एक्स बाई जी एक्स फॉर्म में होना चाहिए। देयर हैज टू बी अ फंक्शन इन द न्यूमरेटर, देयर हैज टू बी अ फंक्शन इन द डिनोमिनेटर। और जो भी क्वेश्चन हमें दिया रहेगा, डायरेक्ट लिमिट पुट करने के बाद क्या तो 0 by 0 फॉर्म वो दिखेगा, या फिर इन्फिनिटी बाई इन्फिनिटी फॉर्म वो दिखेगा, तो हम बोलेंगे ये इनडिटरमिनेट फॉर्म है और उसको डील करने के लिए हमें एक सेपरेट मेथड जिसका नाम है एल हॉस्पिटल वो डिस्कस करना होगा. सो नाउ वी गेट इनटू दिस टॉपिक व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एल हॉस्पिटल्स रूल. So what does L hospital says that if you have a situation limit x tends to 0 f of x by g of x is equals to let us say 0 by 0 form, L hospital permits us that we can go for derivative of the numerator separately and derivative of the denominator separately, as in you do not consider this as fx by gx and we need to differentiate, matlab hame quotient rule apply karna hoga, no. We are differentiating the numerator separately. Fx ko differentiate kiya, we got f dash x. Gx ko differentiate kiya, we got g dash x. L hospital ne kaha ki agar aapke paas aisa format hai, limiting value directly put karne ke baad 0 by 0 ya fir infinity by infinity form aata hai, you can go for derivative of the numerator and denominator separately. After having differentiated, you once again put the limit. Let us say limit put karne ke baad fir se 0 by 0 form aa gaya. So we still have the permission to differentiate it one more time. So it becomes f double dash x, g double dash x. Once again, what happened? Ye jo pehli baar differentiated format aaya, usme humne limit ko directly put kiya. Once again, indeterminate form came. We are allowed to differentiate it one more time. F dash x ko differentiate kiya, we got f double dash x. G dash x ko differentiate kiya, we got g double dash x. So what happened is we double differentiated the function, numerator separately, denominator separately. Once again, we will be trying to put the limit. This saga continues until and unless we get a real number as the final answer. Agar is step mein bhi 0 by 0 form aaya, toh hume fir se triple derivative ke paas jana tha. Now there is a common question in everybody's mind that when do we know how to stop? Pehla tarika to maine bata diya, real number. Aur is process ko kafi elongate karne se acha hai. What I will suggest that every single time you are differentiating, before you putting the limit, you simplify the derivative. As in apply the mathematical concept, jahan kuch cancellation, kuch common term, simplify. Jo bhi simplify hoga, you simplify, then go for substitution. See, still you are getting 0 by 0. You now differentiate the simplified function, not the actual function you obtained. Jo function hamara simplify ho gaya hai, isko aap differentiate kijiye, you will be taking very less number of steps. So this is what is L hospital. Having said that, if I take a very simple question number one, first of all hum dekhenge question kya hai. The question is to evaluate limit x tends to 4, and in the numerator we have x power 4 minus 256. Denominator mein we have x square minus 16. So we first try to directly substitute the value. 4 ko hum directly put karne ki koshish kar rahe hain. So what happens in the numerator? It becomes 4 to the power 4 minus 256. And in the denominator, it becomes 4 square minus 16. In place of x, humne directly 4 ko put kiya. So 4 to the power 4 will give me 256. With that, we have a minus 256 also. Denominator mein 4 square will give me 16 minus 16. What you can see is 0 by 0 form. 0 by 0 form is indeterminate. So, matlab hume L hospital ka istamal yahan pe karna hai. Aur L hospital ne kya kaha hai? That you go for derivative. So, limit x tends to 4 will be carried forward until we substitute the limit. Now, as I said, derivative of the numerator separately and derivative of the denominator separately. Don't even think to apply quotient rule, product rule. Product rule apply hoga agar numerator mein do functions product mein honge. But quotient rule bilkul apply nahi hoga. We don't need to differentiate considering it as a one function. These are two separate functions, two separate derivatives will be taking place. So x power 4 derivative will give me 4x cube, and 256 being a constant, derivative will give me 0. In the denominator, x square ka derivative is 2x, 16 ka derivative is 0. So in the next step, it is limit x tends to 4. We can see it is 4x cubed by 2x. I had said earlier ki jaise hi hamare paas jo bhi function aaye, before we try to substitute, we will first try to simplify the function obtained. Uske baad hum dekhenge. Isko humne simplify kiya, so 2 and 4 got cancelled 2, and this 1x and the power get cancelled. So basically what we have, limit x tends to 4, 2 times the x square. Now it's 2 times the x square. First of all, there is no denominator, as in there is no function in the denominator. That means the concept of now L-hospital is now being stopped here. Moreover, if we substitute the limit, so 2 into 4 square will give me 32, which happens to be a real number, and this is our final answer. So the very first question was extremely elaborating to make us understand jo humne step bataya tha previous page mein, previous slide mein, ki once you differentiate, don't simply jump in putting the limit. First, you try to simplify by cancelling out the common terms or any other LCM adjustments are required. Once you have, we are done with the simplification, go for putting the limit. If the limit still says 0 by 0, then go for differentiating the simplified form, not the originally obtained form. Once you keep in mind this trick, your question will not get too much complicated. And we will end up getting the answer maybe max at the third step, third derivative. And that too, very rare kind of questions will be faced. So, yahan pe humne dekha, single derivative humne kiya. Simplify karne ke baad, hume double derivative ka requirement bhi nahi hai. 0 by 0 form pehle hi eliminate ho gaya. In the similar form, similar way, let us take question number 2, which says limit x tends to pi by 4. We have 1 minus tan x here, that is whole divided by cos 2x. And this is a 2009 board question, I see. See, just by looking at the fraction that we have a numerator and we have a denominator, we will not simply jump for L-hospital rule. We need to first verify and justify also ki limit put karne pe wo kya to 0 by 0 ya infinity by infinity format le raha hai. Until and unless we are extremely sure about the 0 by 0 and infinity by infinity, we won't be able to apply the L-hospital rule. L-hospital rule ka condition hi yahi hai ki ye applicable to indeterminate form hona hoga. So, agar humne directly pi by 4 put kiya, it becomes 1 minus tan pi by 4 upon cos 2 into pi by 4, which give me 1 minus 1, and cos 2 into pi by 4 is cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 90, that is 0. So, basically, we got 0 by 0 form. So, one thing is clear that L-hospital is required here. So, now L-hospital is required. We will do the derivative part of the numerator and denominator separately. So derivative of 1 is 0. Tan x will give me sec square x. And niche cos 2x, first of all, it will give us minus sine 2x with chain rule, but 2 will also be there. Having said that, we will first cancel out the minus sign from numerator and denominator. So it becomes 6 square x, and in the denominator we have 2 times sine 2x. We don't think that it's getting simplified further, so we will try the limit part. As in pehle rough me check kar lenge. So it is 6 square pi by 4, and denominator made 2 sine 2 into pi by 4. Sec pi by 4 is root 2, jiska square karenge, or niche 2 into sine 90, sine 90 is 1. So basically it is 2 by 2, as in we can now substitute this as here, sec square pi by 4 upon 2 sine 2 into pi by 4, which is root 2 square, 2 into 1. Answer is 2 by 2, that is 1. One thing we must have noticed the moment we substituted the limit here, as in we were parallelly checking on the rough. Rough mein humne check kiya ki L-hospital ka wapas requirement hai ki nahi. We got sure, so this rough work is anyhow not a part of the question. We understood kya bhi ye calculation, we can do it in our mind also. Ki pi by 4 substitute karke dekh rahe, it is coming 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, dono mein se kuch ek aa raha hai ki nahi. Nahi aa raha hai, matlab substitution hai. Aur limit word ab aana band ho gaya because humne substitution kar liya. Moving to the third problem. सिचुएशन इज लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू जीरो, एक्स ई टू द पावर एक्स माइनस लॉग वन प्लस एक्स अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर. So here, once again, we need to judge first of all कि question इस domain का है कि नहीं, L hospital का है कि नहीं, या indeterminate का है कि नहीं. So वही करेंगे हम, rough में check कर लेंगे पहले that it's zero by zero form or not. So let us directly substitute. It is zero multiplied by e to the power zero minus log one plus zero. It is just mere substitution. X के जगह पे हर जगह हमें zero put कर देना है. That is a limiting part. So zero multiplied by anything is zero. Log one is zero. Niche is zero. Basically, we got zero by zero form. So we could see the requirement of the L hospital. Okay. Having said that, हमें पता है L hospital का मतलब numerator and denominator को separately differentiate करना है with respect to x. That we know. So let us do. This is limit extends to zero. Now you see in the numerator we have two functions separated with the minus sign, and the first function happens to be product of two more functions. So maybe we can show this step also. D dx of x e to the power x minus d dx of log one plus x whole divided by d dx of x square. So let us evaluate. This is limit extends to zero. D dx of x e power x will give me x e power x plus e power x as per the product rule. We very well know this. Minus this d dx of log one by one plus x will give us one by one plus x. Now this whole thing is divided by 2x. So what we can do here? We don't get to see that it's getting too much simplified. हम क्या करेंगे? इसको फिर से limit put करके देखते हैं यहाँ पे. So zero multiplied by anything, it is zero. E power zero, this will give us one, and this is one by one plus zero, as in this will also give us one. So here we have a one. One minus one, zero. On नीचे में two into zero is also zero. So once again we could see the requirement is of L hospital, and this is not getting further simplified. तो हम क्या करेंगे इसको? One more time, differentiate करेंगे. Once again, we could see x e power x. So the answer will be x e power x plus e power x. That is, I have differentiated the first term so far. Next, this e power x will give us e power x again. And lastly, we have one by one plus x. इसका derivative हमें पता है, it becomes one by one plus x का whole square with a positive sign. Because the derivative itself will give us minus, 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 plus ho gaya. Now this is whole divided by 2x ka derivative will give us 2. Now we can see denominator mein 2 aa gaya. Matlab, we don't think is 0 by 0 form all aa sakta hai. Of course not. Denominator mein 2 hai. So let us now substitute the limit directly. So x e power x will anyhow give us 0. E power x, it becomes e power 0 plus e power 0. That is 1 plus 1. And here it is 1 plus 0 power whole square upon 2. So it is 3 by 2 is the answer for this question. Now the next question here is, so limit extends to 0, x minus sin x upon x square sin x. So sabse pehle format ko jo judge karna hai, jo humne algorithm sikha hai, the steps. वो सारे स्टेप्स पहले करेंगे. दैट इज पुटिंग द एक्स वैल्यू जीरो, इट बिकम जीरो. साइन जीरो इज जीरो अपॉन जीरो स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाइड बाय साइन जीरो इज जीरो. एनीहाउ वी गॉट जीरो बाय जीरो फॉर्म. सो वी अंडरस्टूड द रिक्वायरमेंट इज ऑफ एल हॉस्पिटल. बट देर आर सर्टेन प्रॉब्लम्स दैट इफ वी डू नॉट स्टार्ट इन एन इंटेलिजेंट वे वी विल गेट स्टक विद द प्रॉब्लम. ऑलरेडी वी कैन सी दैट वी हैव एक्स स्क्वायर साइन एक्स इन द डिनोमिनेटर. डेरिवेटिव करेंगे तो प्रोडक्ट रूल लगने वाला है. फिर आ जाएगा एक्स स्क्वायर कॉस एक्स, देन टू एक्स साइन एक्स. वंस अगेन वी हैव टू, इफ एट ऑल द सिचुएशन डिमांड्स वन मोर डेरिवेटिव, देन वी विल बी हैविंग टू मोर प्रोडक्ट रूल्स. सी पहला अगर इसको हम डेरिवेटिव करते हैं तो ये क्या आ जाएगा, एक्स स्क्वायर कॉस एक्स प्लस टू एक्स साइन एक्स. अगर मान लेते हैं किसी वजह से ऐसा सिचुएशन हुआ कि हमें फिर से डिफ्रेंशिएट करना पड़ेगा, नाउ वन सेकेंड प्रोडक्ट रूल, वन सेकेंड प्रोडक्ट रूल. एंड दैट इज वाई देर आर सर्टेन क्वेश्चन वेयर वी कैन टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड लिमिट्स. If we recall the standard limits formula we have done in the previous class, as in the class 11th concept, the standard limit ke kuch formula jo yahan pe kaafi kaam aane wale hain, that I'm just making you write. Number one, limit x tends to 0, sine x upon x, that is limit x tends to 0, sine x upon x is equals to limit x tends to 0 x by sin x is equals to 1. Function sin x by x ho ya x by sin x, dono case mein answer 1 hoga, provided limit x tends to 0 hona chahiye. Same logic mein if we have limit x tends to 0 tan x by x or limit x tends to 0 x by tan x, both the case answer will be 1. And third, limit x tends to 0 log 1 plus x upon x is equals to 1. So sare standard limits ke formula hame yaad nahi karne, this 2 3 will do, and maybe 4 1 also you take it. Limit x tends to 0 e to the power x minus 1 by x is equals to log e, jise hum 1 hi bolenge, because we know calculus mein log e with base e is 1. So having understood and this principle if we apply here, we get to see कि अगर हम सबसे पहले क्या करते हैं, नीचे में जो sin x है उसको अलग करने की कोशिश करते हैं, as in I am making it x minus sin x upon x square into 1 by sin x. This is very much understandable कि हमने ऐसा कर सकते हैं और हमने ऐसा किया. करने के बाद limit x tends to 0, this is x minus sin x upon, if I make it this thing as a x cube, so definitely I have to multiply a x in the numerator, so it becomes x by sin x. The logic, why did I do this? Because I wanted to incorporate the standard limit formula, and that is why I have a concept ready here, x by sin x. First of all, what we will do, we will segregate the limit. So limit x tends to 0, this is x minus sin x upon x cube. It is our one limit multiplied by the second limit is limit x tends to 0. It is x upon sin x. What we see that this limit has is a standard limit. Answer will be 1. So in the next step, we just need to take care of the limit, which is the first one, limit x tends to 0, x minus sin x upon x cube. Now, अब हमें जो भी एल हॉस्पिटल लगाना है वो हम यहाँ लगाएंगे, सो दैट वी गॉट रेड ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट रूल कॉन्सेप्ट. देखो डिनोमिनेटर में सिर्फ एक ही फंक्शन है, हम आसानी से डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकते हैं. सो डिफ्रेंशिएट हमने किया, लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू 0, ऊपर आ गया 1 माइनस कॉस एक्स एंड नीचे में आ गया 3 एक्स स्क्वायर. हमने फिर से चेक किया, so cos 0 will give us 1, 1 minus 1 0, niche 0 put karne pe 0, it is once again 0 by 0, we will have to differentiate it one more time. So limit x tends to 0, now minus cos x ka derivative will be plus sin x, and niche we got 6x. Ye simplify further ho nahi sakta, once again substitute karke dekho, jab humne 0 put kiya, sin 0 is 0, niche fir se 0 aa gaya, so we need to go for one more derivative. So that is equals to limit x tends to 0. Sin x will give me cos x. 6x ka derivative 6. Now, niche mein 6 aa gaya, matlab aur differentiate nahi hoga. We can go for direct substitution now. Cos 6, cos 0 is 1. 1 by 6 is our final answer. You can see the last 3-4 steps were extremely easy to differentiate just because we have taken care of something at the very beginning of the question. As in, I'm talking about which part of the question? I'm talking about this part. Imagine this would not have been separated earlier, the question could have become very much complicated by now. So humne ek major chunk ko one substitute karke khatam kar diya, and this is the final answer. So this also needs to be taken care of in Hill Hospital, that at times if we don't divert the step the question goes to a dead end. Similar kind of problem we have it here, that is number 5. It says limit extends to 0 log 1 plus x cube upon sine cube x. The sine cube x is can create problem for us. So, हमने सबसे पहले यही किया limit extends to 0. Sine cube इसलिए problem कर सकता है क्योंकि sine cube को differentiate करने के बाद we will get something very complicated. As in 3 sine square into cos. और अगर गलती से उसको वापस differentiate करना पड़ा तब it becomes too much of a complicated part. So, हमने सबसे पहले किया log 1 plus x cube को अलग लिखा and 1 by sine cube x को अलग लिखा. और अपने मन से हमने यहां पे एक x cube provide कर दिया because we wanted to provide a x cube here also, just like the previous sum. Now, what we can do, we can segregate the limit, as in limit extends to 0, log 1 plus x cube upon x cube, it is one function, multiplied by limit extends to 0. Can I write this as x by sine x whole cube? Of course, we can do, because हम देख पा रहे हैं इसके पास भी क्यूब है, इसके पास भी क्यूब है, हमने इसको whole cube में convert कर दिया. Now, needless to mention that this will give us 1. So, in the next step, this becomes limit extends to 0, log of 1 plus x cube upon x cube into 1 car cube. So, the second limit got evaluated. Now, what we have is only this function, जिसको हम evaluate करना है, तो सबसे पहले हमने 0 put करके देखा, log 1 plus 0 will give us log 1, और हमें पता है log 1 का value 0 होता है, नीचे 0 का cube, ये भी 0 हो गया, मतलब फिर से हमारा format आ गया 0 by 0, इस चीज को समझेंगे, अगर हमने यहाँ पे 0 का value put किया, so 1 plus 0 will give us 1, and we know log 1 is equals to nothing but 0, similarly नीचे x cube के जगह पे 0 put करेंगे, तो ये आ गया 0 by 0 form. मतलब जो हमारा required form है, वो required form आ गया. और required form permit करता है, हमें differentiate करना. So log को differentiate करेंगे. We got the element in the denominator, multiplied by 3x square of course. As per what? Chain rule. हमने पहले log को differentiate किया. Log को differentiate किया, तो जो element था नीचे आ गया. अब element को differentiate किया, we got 3x square. और ये जो denominator x cube था, इसको differentiate कर रहे हैं. So this is 3x square. What we get to see, the 3x square in the numerator and 3x square in the denominator got cancelled. We are just one step away from the sum. This is 1 by 1 plus x cube now. Our target is to first directly substitute and see what we get to see. 1 happens to be a real number, can be accepted as the answer to this question. Once again, you could see this last part was smooth enough. Just because we have taken care of something at the very beginning. So this is what we have as the content, and this let this be the last question of this video. Yahan pe hum dekh pa rahe hain limit extends to infinity is given, or the e to the power x plus 3x cube upon 4 e power x upon 2x square is the given function. So that formality part, we will definitely take care of. If we put infinity directly, we get 3 into infinity, because we know infinity cube is nothing but infinity. Then 4 e to the power infinity plus 2 into infinity. Basically, infinity plus infinity, we got this form. Maybe this is the first question we have taken where we have got infinity by infinity as the indeterminate form. हमने class के beginning में कहा था कि दो format हमें देखने हैं L-hospital के अंदर. One is 0 by 0 and next is infinity by infinity. Or dono format ke andar L-hospital applicable hai with the same principle. You differentiate the numerator separately. You differentiate the denominator separately. Now, if this is the situation, let us do the needful, that is differentiating. So limit extends to infinity. E power x ko differentiate ke the same. Or x cube ko differentiate karenge. This is 3x square. Niche mein we have 4 e power x remains same. और x square को differentiate किया, we got 2x. Function को पहले simplified form में लिखते हैं, so it is e power x plus 9x square upon 4 e power x plus 4x. सिचुएशन वन सेकंड डिमांड्स सब्स्टिट्यूशन. देखो ये फिर से इनफिनिटी 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 इनफिनिटी, तो वी विल गो फॉर वन मोर डेरिवेटिव. मे बी पास में हम लिख देते हैं स्टिल इनफिनिटी बाय इनफिनिटी फॉर्म. क्वेश्चन अगर सब्जेक्टिव पैटर्न का होता है तो हमें बहुत सारी बातें ख्याल रखनी है, लाइक राइटिंग दिस स्टेप्स कि हमने वापस डिफरेंशिएट किया. बिफोर दैट यू हैव टू राइट इनफिनिटी बाय इनफिनिटी फॉर्म. नेक्स्ट, so 9x square को e power x को differentiate किया, we got the same 9x square differentiated, we got 18x. यहाँ पे 4 e power x is there और यहाँ पे आ गया 4. so are we in a position to substitute the limit? I don't think so because once again it will give us the same infinity by infinity. इसको हमें एक और by differentiate करना है, at least इस step में तो differentiate करना है. we don't know what happens in the next one. so this is limit extends to infinity. e power x, this becomes now 18, and in the denominator we just have 4 e power x. Still we are not in a position to substitute because this is infinity, this is still infinity, so this is infinity by infinity form. One good part about this question that the derivative is not complicated, we are easily able to proceed with the sum. Now this is e power x and this is 4 e power x. E power x now got cancelled. X power infinity, x tends to infinity 1 by 4. No position to substitute. Now acceptable real number is 1 by 4. This becomes our answer. So we could see we differentiated the first, second, third and fourth time here. Char bar differentiation humne kiya hai. Four times derivative. And this was easy because the derivative part was easy. We were able to proceed with the derivative since the question steps were not getting simplified or infinity tha, to isliye maybe char bar differentiate karke answer aa gaya. Because generally infinity wale question simplify hone mein typical ho jayenge. And you should know one thing, e to the power infinity is infinity, but if it is e to the power minus infinity, answer will be taken as zero. You should note down this. अगर पावर में नेगेटिव इन्फिनिटी है तो आंसर जीरो होता है, और पावर में पॉजिटिव इन्फिनिटी है तो आंसर इन्फिनिटी होता है. ये जनरली एक कंफ्यूजन रहता है. सो यू प्रोसीड विद दिस टॉपिक, डू ट्राई द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चंस. वी हैव टेकन अ फ्यू बोर्ड क्वेश्चंस आल्सो टुडे. दिस कवर्स द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दिस ईयर्स इनडिटरमिनेट फॉर्म. देयर इज नॉट इवन अ सिंगल बिट ऑफ पोर्शन लेफ्ट और दैट वी डिड नॉट डिस्कस इन द क्लास टुडे. ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है, जो भी सिलेबस के अंदर है कंटेंट में है. एज इन द प्रिस्क्राइब टेक्स्ट बुक इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एमएल अग्रवाल, आप उसके एक एक क्वेश्चन एग्जाम्पल के साथ कंप्लीट कर सकते हैं. स्टिल यू फील एनी डिफिकल्टी इन दिस, यू कैन डेफिनेटली कॉन्टेक्ट मी फॉर द सेम. दैट विल बी ऑल. थैंक यू.